Good morning, students. Welcome back, and I hope that you all are safe at your home. Now today we will cover derivation tree. As previously told in the class, what is derivation, what is derivation tree? Let's have a look again, what is a derivation tree? Now suppose in a context-free grammar, a question comes where an input string is given to us and it is asked that whether this string is accepted or not, in the same way as it was asked in finite state automata. Now, the process of finding out that whether the string is accepted by this context-free grammar or not is called derivation. Basically, the steps we follow to derive that input string starting from the start symbol is called derivation. We derive the string which is given in the question to find out whether the given context-free grammar is accepting that string or not. And this whole process of deriving that string, checking that string acceptance is called derivation. Let us understand this with one example. You can see a grammar which is given on the right hand side. It is having 7 productions, 4 variables A, B, C, S, 3 terminals A, B, C, S start symbol, and 7 productions. We have to use these productions starting from a start symbol to derive an input string written with on left hand side with red color, double A, double B, double C. We have to check whether the given string is accepted by the given context-free grammar. Now to check this, we start as shown in the slide on a step 1, that S changes to A, B, C. It means that S variable can be replaced by variable A, B, C as given by P1. P1 is the rule of production 1, which is shown on the right hand side of the string. Now there are 2 methods in which we can derive the string. One is we can replace A, the variable A which is written on the right hand side of the production at on leftmost corner, or we can replace the variable C which is written on the right hand side at rightmost corner of the production. When we derive the input by taking all the variables from left hand side, it is called leftmost derivation. And when we derive from taking all the variables on from right hand side, it is called rightmost derivation. The example given in